Welcome to the In the Church TV and radio broadcast, where we are shining the light of God's Word in the church to discuss and resolve real everyday issues that are taking place around the world, throughout the nation, exposing the good, the bad, and the ugly as we engage in powerful conversations with our expertise, opinions, and revealing everything through the truth of God's Word on every topic imaginable. And so we thank you for joining us in the church on tonight. I am your host, Apostle Deron Shay Dorn, and I'm excited to be with you on tonight in the church. Amen, amen, and amen. Glory be unto God in this place. My God, in the name of Jesus, we just bless God because he got greatness in store for us. We thank God for what he's doing for such a time as this, as he is just releasing and just pouring out in our lives and then just equipping us and developing us in this word of truth. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. And so we just bless the name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Because God is doing a great work. He's doing a great work in us so that he can do an even mightier work through us. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Somebody has to catch that. He's doing a great work in us so that he may do a phenomenal work out of us, dynamic people of God. Amen. In the majestic name of Jesus. My God, my God. So on tonight, I told you guys, for those who joined us last week, we had a phenomenal time dealing with identity crisis in the church. And it was just so awesome. And the way God was moving and flowing, I didn't even get a chance to get to many of the things that I desired to. So we are definitely doing identity crisis in the church part two on tonight, to further get into this teaching, this training, this learning. Amen. I'm glory to God, so that somebody can be helped, be saved, be delivered, be set free, so that they will no longer be hidden behind the baggage of things of life that they have inquired, so that they may walk in purpose and fulfill their destinies. Amen. In the majestic name of Jesus, glory to God. And so, as always, people of God, we're going to hit the throne of grace first to get us started, to get us moving right now, dynamic people of God. My God, amen, amen, and amen. To God be the glory. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Let us go to the throne. Oh, gracious Father, we thank you in this hour and in this moment. We thank you, Lord God, for what it is that you're about to release in the church on tonight. We thank you, Lord God, that right now you're taking over the airways, oh God, so that there will be no interference or interruptions, oh God, so that children can hear with clarity what it is that you're speaking directly to them, Father, in the name of Jesus, so that they would no longer be hindered. They would no longer be bound, oh God, in a false identity. They would no longer move around in falsehood, Almighty King, in the name of Jesus, as they come into understand who they are in you, Almighty God, hallelujah, as you break the stronghold of the enemy, my God, in the lives of your dear beloved children, in the majestic name of Jesus, glory to your name, oh God. You are mighty, you are glorious, you are amazing, and my God, we can definitely trust you. Holy are you, Lord. We thank you, Lord, that right now, glory to God, that you're going to uproot the lies and deception of the enemy out of the lives of your people, God, that every, Lord God, place of rejection and every, Lord God, a place of deception, every society label on today, that it is going to be stripped from your people, that you're uprooting it, Father, in the majestic name of Jesus, glory to God, And even as you're uprooting, oh God, that you are putting in them, oh God, hallelujah, your seed of righteousness, that you are God, that you are releasing, oh God, the truth, that they're fearfully and wonderfully made, that Lord God, that they are successful, that they are amazing, that Lord God, that they are flawless, Father, in the name of Jesus, that they are smart and intelligent, Father, that they, oh God, hallelujah, is everything that you have called for them to be, that they lack absolutely nothing because they are in you, Almighty King, in the name of Jesus. We thank you right now that it is your word of truth. You said it in your word that you shall know the truth and the truth shall set you free, and that freedom is being released in the church on tonight, that healing is being released in the church on tonight, that deliverance is being, Lord God, released in the church on tonight, in the majestic name of Jesus. We're declaring and decreeing in this place that your children are coming out, oh God. They're coming out from behind the deceptions, behind the lies, behind, oh God, the falsehood, that they are coming behind, from behind the baggage, the word curses and the label societies that have been placed upon their lives. That on today, oh God, that their grave clothes are removed in the name of Jesus, and that they are clothed in your truth, Almighty God, so they may walk, they may rise up in wholeness and advance and do that in which you are called for them to do, in the majestic name of Jesus. We declare and declare in this place that there will be no more delays, that they will no longer run a circle or basia, that they will no longer deny, oh God, their purpose. They will no longer deny who they are. They will no longer make excuses, oh God, for moving in that in which you have called for them to do, in the majestic name of Jesus. But no, God, that they would rise up, oh God, in the power of your word and the truth of your might, Almighty King, in the majestic name of Jesus, that they would move boldly, oh God, that they would be strong and courageous, oh my God, that they would meditate on your word day in and day out, for that they will be successful in all of their ways, that they will advance forth, oh God, in every place that they tread their feet upon, that you would give unto them in the majestic name of Jesus. Hallelujah, glory to your name, God. Have your way, God, have your way. Have your way, God. Hey, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Have your way in the name of Jesus. Glory, glory, glory. Hallelujah to your name, oh God. We give you glory. We thank you for the blood that cleanses, purifies, and make whole, oh God. And we just plead the blood of Jesus upon, your God, your people's life. Hallelujah, Lord God, the blood that sustains, the blood that make whole in this place, in the majestic name of Jesus. Move, God, breathe upon your people right now. Hallelujah, Lord God, so that they may get the wind, the lift them up, yeah, God, hallelujah, and cause them to soar to new heights and destinations that's marked out in you, that will move them, oh God, from one dispensation of faith to, amen, to the next, oh God, from one dispensation of glory to the next, Father, in the majestic name of Jesus. Strengthen your sons and daughters throughout the land, Almighty King. Have your way in their lives. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Glory, glory, glory to your holy and righteous name in this place. My God, my God, my God, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Father, we thank you for meeting us in the church, and we thank you as we humble ourselves unto your hand, that you would do this, as we commit this broadcast to you, that you will do it, oh God, what is needed. We thank you, oh God, that we will speak from the throne on today. Hallelujah, the word of power, word of activation and penetration. Hallelujah, that transform the hearts and the minds of man, so that they may be set free, that they may be whole, that they may be delivered, my God, in Jesus' name. Amen, amen, and amen. To God be the absolute glory. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Glory, 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 glory. Glory be unto God in this place, in the name of Jesus. Amen, amen, and amen. Hallelujah. I'm dynamic people of God. Amen. Go ahead and get your Bibles and turn to 1 Samuel 10. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Also, get over to Ephesians, the book of Ephesians, chapter 4 and 25 as well. Amen. Tonight, we're dealing with identity crisis in the church, part 2. My God, in the name of Jesus, glory to God. In addition, people of God, go ahead and share this broadcast on your social media platforms so that those that you know that they can get in on this powerful conversation and which it is that God is releasing in the church on tonight so that his people can be set free, made whole, delivered, my God, in the majestic name of Jesus, glory to God. We're going to... My God, hallelujah, glory to God, thank you, Jesus, hallelujah. So go ahead and do that, amen, for us. We're going to go ahead right now in this particular hour and get into a song of worship, amen, unto the Lord, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, glory to God, as we worship further into his presence and prepare for the release that God is getting ready to release in the church on tonight. Amen. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. And amen.
We stand in awe of your sovereignty. redeemed from the hand of the enemy. Thank you, Jesus. I am one of the redeemed. Not of any good that I have done or ever will do. I fall short each and every day.
And Lord, I've even strayed.
But your love for me way back on Calvary paid the price for me.
You kept your hand on me.
Yeah. I am redeemed from the hand of my enemy.
Lord, I thank you for sending
your only son,
for saving a wretch like me. You gave me life abundantly.
For my mountain high,
for my mountain high, my valley low,
you've done so much for me. You didn't have to do it, Lord.
Lord, I'm so glad you did.
I am redeemed from the hand of my enemy, in whom we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sin, according to the riches of his grace. What a mighty God I serve. As I look around, I blessings overflowing,
new mercy, new grace,
each and every day. So unworthy, Lord, to even speak your name.
A love that's overwhelming, you died and rose to save a sinner like me.
Redeemed from the hand of my enemy.
Lord, I thank you for sending
your only son,
for saving a wretch like me. You gave me life abundantly.
For my mountain high,
for my valley low,
you've done so much for me. You didn't have to do it, Lord. The hand of my enemy. Psalms 107, verse 2. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so, whom he has redeemed from the hand of my enemy. I've been given
this because of the blood.
No rock will cry out in my place.
I've been given this new life.
Give Jesus glory to God. We just bless God in this place. In the name of Jesus, glory, 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 glory to the Lord. My God, in the name of Jesus, hallelujah. You have been given a new life because of the blood, because of the blood of Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus, because of the blood of Jesus. Amen. Glory to God. It has been given unto you so freely. Hallelujah. It didn't cost you anything. My God, in the name of Jesus, glory, glory be unto God in this place. And so we just bless the Lord. We bless the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. We bless the Lord at all times, and his praise will be upon our lips. Glory to God as we bless his name and magnify him in this place in the name of Jesus. We thank God that he loved us enough not to keep us in the same place. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. That he loved us enough, my God, to die on the cross on our behalf. That he loved us enough, my God, in the name of Jesus, glory to God, that we no longer have to live under the bondage, my God, hallelujah, of the bondage of our adversary, in the name of Jesus, glory to God, that we are free to be, we are free to live, amen, glory to God, thank you, Jesus, hallelujah, in the Lord, my God, my God, my God, my God, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. We don't have to have and operate in these identity crises, hallelujah. We don't no longer have to live under bondage, amen, lies and deception of the enemy because of what Jesus has done for us on the cross, people of God, in the name of Jesus. My God, my God, my God. God is just absolutely amazing. He's absolutely amazing, people of God, with all that he is doing in our lives. Amen. I thank you so much for sharing this broadcast on your social media platform so that others that you know can get in on this awesome, awesome, awesome conversation on tonight, that they may be healed, set free, and delivered as well, in the majestic name of Jesus. Glory. Glory be unto God in this place, my God. In the name of Jesus, amen, amen, and amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. So on tonight, I want to get us started here. We're going to, I told you guys, we're definitely going to dive into 1 Samuel chapter 9. Amen, glory to God. But I want us to start here on tonight so that it can give us and embrace us for the foundation of what's getting taken place. We're dealing with identity crisis in the church. And as we look around society and, amen, as a whole, and we can look in the church and we can see the behavior and the way that, and the lifestyle that the people are living, my God, in the church, we can definitely see and understand that there is an identity crisis. Amen. Hallelujah. My God, that there is an identity crisis in the church, even though, amen, this word of truth, amen, defines who we are. And God has called us out of darkness into this marvelous light. Many of us are still living in the dark. My God. Still living in the dark. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Still operating in lawlessness. Still, my God, operating, amen, out of our flesh. When we can have questionable issues about our sexual orientation, right? When it's clearly defined in the Word of God, amen, glory to God, how God has designed us. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. And it's male and female. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. And when it comes to marriage and relationship, He didn't shape or He didn't bring into fruition someone, a male, amen, glory to God, to live a lifestyle as a female, or a female to live a lifestyle as a male. You know, that's an identity issue, an identity crisis that is taking place in somebody's life. Something happened and ripped away or stripped or stole their identity from them and caused them to live in falsehood. And the same thing alike. God didn't call us to be in and out of bed, right, amen, with this person and that person. He didn't call us to have promiscuous behavior. To live a life of promiscuous behavior, that is an identity crisis. You don't feel that you are good enough for one person, that you don't feel that you'll be able, and you don't trust God, that He has definitely has somebody for you. And so you don't feel that you are, some people don't feel that they are marriage material. Why? Because they have an identity crisis. There's an identity crisis going on. And so, amen, glory to God. So to make me feel better about myself, you know, people sleep from one bed to the next bed and over to the next bed and things of that nature and still get no gratification and still, amen, glory to God. They just have a temporary, but they find themselves back in the same cycle. That's why they're from one bed to the next, one man from the next man, the next woman to the next woman, trying to be satisfied. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. My God, in this place. So we just got to deal with the identity crisis going on and just so many other different things. Even when we can be in a place where we're comparing ourselves to other people and we're competing against other people, that's an identity crisis. That is an identity crisis. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. It is always an identity crisis when you think that you can compare or compete with an original design. And so if you would just be authentically you and who it is that God has called you to be, amen, glory to God, thank you, Jesus, and move in your authentic self, you won't be trying to outdo anybody else. Why? Because you would know that you, amen, glory to God, you're the best in what it is that God has called you to do. Amen, hallelujah, glory to God. And so you would dare not. You would dare not walk, move, operate in a place of mistaken identity. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. You would dare not compare yourself with somebody else. My God. Right. Amen. Hallelujah. Stay in your lane, and you'll just be every day. You'll show up being the best you that you are. Identity crisis. See, if we can recall the Pharisees and the Sadducees, they had identity crisis. Amen. Glory to God. And because they had identity crisis, it caused them to build a hatred in their heart for Christ. It positioned them in a place where, amen, that they were desiring to kill the Christ, right? My God, because of the isms that was going on the inside of them. And so they decided in their heart, because they were seeing that the people was drawn to the Lord. And they seen how, you know, the man and amen, glory to God, the man was you know, clinging to Christ. And so it left them with, my God, just a major identity crisis. My God. In the name of Jesus, Lord God, help us in this place. Lord, help us in this place, my God, in the majestic name of Jesus. Because we really, really, really need the Lord, dynamic people of God, so that he can help us, amen, in all that's going on and taking place in our lives, so that we can get to the destination and the place, amen, in which God has called, chosen, ordained, appointed, amen, and anointed for our lives. We got to come from all of these identity crises, that we're dealing with in the land. Amen. And the time is like right now. Like the time is right now, people of God. I mean, right now. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. And so, if you just be you, amen, glory to God. We didn't see the disciples comparing and competing with one another. No, they didn't do that whatsoever. They knew they, amen, glory to God, they was anointed to do what they was anointed to do. And they didn't fight one another to do it either. They didn't fight one another to do it, people of God. They just owned their space. They owned their space and did what they needed to do. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. And so we got to begin to operate and move in that same ordinance, in that same place, and in that same space as well, dynamic people of God. Amen. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So let us get in the word. Let us get in the word. I want to get in the meat of the word. Amen. I want us to get into the meat of this word, because it's going to help and it's going to save somebody. Amen. It's going to change somebody's life. It's going to change somebody's life, people of God, in the majestic name of Jesus. And so we just thank the Lord for just changing alive on today. Amen. In the majestic name of Jesus. So let us go ahead and get started in this word. So I want us to start here, and then we're going to get to Samuel, because it's going to all tie in. Amen. Glory to God. I'm going to get to 1 Samuel chapter 9. So Ephesians 4:24, it says this, and I'll come back and talk about some other things, because I want to deal with the doubt and all of that other stuff. Oh, never mind. We'll walk it out through Samuel, the book of Samuel. Okay, so Ephesians 4:23 says this. It says, therefore, putting away lying, let each one of you speak the truth with his neighbor, for we are members of one another. That's one version. Another version says it like this. Therefore, each of you must put off falsehood and speak truthfully to his neighbor, for we are all members of one body. And so what I want to deal with right here is this word falsehood. Falsehood is lying, distortion, fabrication, untruth. Amen. Glory to God. It is deception. It is misrepresentation. Amen. Glory to God. It is misrepresentation. Many of us have been living in a misrepresentation. We've been misrepresented. My God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. And so we have been misrepresented, and due to that, people of God, it has called us to live lives, amen, under falsehood. It has caused us to live lives being deceptive. It has caused us to live lives where we have of brokenness, right? Of insecurity. It has caused us to not own our space. It has caused us to be delayed. It has denied us from walking in the truth and who it is that we are, people of God, in the name of Jesus. And God is just saying, enough is enough. Enough is enough. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. And so that the time is now. Amen. That the time is now. The time is now. No more. No longer. Hallelujah. Thank you. No longer. No more will you live under falsehood. No longer. No more will the enemy lie and deceive you. No longer will you live beneath your purpose, beneath your destiny, who it is that God has called forth for you to be, who God has called and chosen you. Amen. In the name of Jesus, glory to God. Go ahead and speak that over your life. Hallelujah. I just believe that even right now that God is uprooting, amen, the strongholds of the adversary that have been choking the very life out of you as it has been lying and deceiving you and keeping you from walking in your true identity. Amen. In the majestic name of Jesus, glory to God in this place. And so we thank the Lord that he's favoring you right now, that he would have you under the sign of my voice on today to hear the release of the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. So we just bless the name of the Father, amen, in this place, in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So, falsehood. So falsehood or a lie does three things in the life of people, right? Falsehood misrepresents the truth. It camouflages and it hides the truth. The person lied to does not know the truth. Therefore, he has to act or live upon a lie. Oh, my God. If the lie is serious, it can be very damaging. Oh, my God. How many of us, if we can just be truthful about it, because I know that it happened in my life. It was, amen, glory to God. That was something that definitely took place in my life where falsehood, I lived in a place of falsehood. And because of that, it hindered me. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. It hindered me in my walk and in my calling. Amen, for accepting the truth of God's word. And so it delayed me in a lot of places in my life. Amen. In the name of Jesus, glory to God. And we just have, we just be truthful about this day. Amen. In the majestic name of Jesus. Glory to God. Also, people of God. This was to what this thing say and just how it got this thing broken down right here in this word. It said, lying or falsehood misrepresent the truth. It camouflages and it hides the truth. The person lied to does not know the truth. Therefore, he has to act or live upon a lie. Amen. So many people's lives have been taken because they've been misrepresented. Amen. Words that have been given to them has misrepresented who they are. Amen. Glory to God. So a serious lie can be damaging. Okay, so a lie about a business deal can cost money and cause terrible losses. A lie about salvation of Jesus Christ can cost a person the hope of eternal life. A lie about loving someone can stir up emotions that lead to destruction. A lie about who somebody is can cause them to live a destructive lifestyle. Lying deceives a person. It leads a person astray. People deceive to get what they want, to seduce people, to cover up or hide things, or to cause harm or hurt. I do believe also in addition on people, God, I mean, we was lied about when they told us you were stupid, you'll never amount to anything, you ain't going to never be anybody, you know, and things of that nature. And they limited what it was that you're able to do, people of God. You have to listen and understand, amen, that the enemy was using other people to hinder you in your growth and development, to hinder you in who it is and what it is that God has called for you in your life. Lies and deception. We know the enemy is the father of lies. Deception. Lying is deception, right? And because lying is deception, it causes misunderstanding. It causes disappointment. It causes helplessness. It causes emotional behaviors. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. It hinders the growth and development. And this is what I was saying earlier, and I don't think I finished a thought. Because I just don't believe, or I want, this is what I want to believe. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. I want to believe that even people of God, when we were told stuff or we were spoken, negative stuff was spoken over our lives, or lies and deceptions or words of falsehood, right? When they were spoken over our lives, it is my desire that when people spoke it, especially those in our families, like our parents and our aunties and grandparents. And so when they would say stuff like that, it just was my prayer that they just were saying these things out of just ignorance, right? That they wasn't saying it to hurt us. They was just had a misunderstanding in who you really are, or they couldn't communicate appropriately. They just didn't know how to communicate appropriately, right? And because of that, they spoke from a place of falsehood or lies and deception in our lives. I'm just going to, you know, amen, glory to God, thank you, Jesus. I just want to just think that was what was going on. I'm hoping that they wasn't maliciously, that they didn't maliciously, you know, say those things, those negative words about us, because they truthfully believe them, they was intentionally doing it to cause harm to us. That's my prayer. Also, falsehood, lies, and deception, it builds wrong relationships. A relationship built upon, a lie is like sinking sand. You can't truly be friends, right? Hallelujah, glory to God. You can't truly develop a friendship or a business relationship or ministry relationship with anyone built on a lie. And so many times we're just so full of pretense. In addition, you can't build a marriage on pretense. Any relationship that's built on a lie, it destroys trust, security, confidence, hope. Oh my God, it really destroys a relationship. But here we're talking about, we're dealing with identity. How is falsehood, amen, and I want us to kind of just get a clear understanding of the things that what falsehood is and what it does. But how is it hindering so many of our lives? Because so many of us are living, amen, glory to God, we're living, walking proof. Because we're wrapped in, amen, false identities that other people have spoken about us, even at, that society have labeled us. Amen. I remember being in that place in my life and coming into the knowledge of truth. And that's what helped us come out of falsehood, by the way. But coming into the knowledge of truth and accepting the truth. When I accept the truth of who God said I was, that I was made in his image and his likeness. Oh, my God. When I accept the truth that he said I'm fearfully and wonderfully made, oh, my God. It just changed my whole entire life. Oh, God. It changed my whole entire life. And I've told you guys the story before. At a moment, I was angry for a moment. But that anger from the pain pushed me into purpose as well. Amen. I was angry because I couldn't believe that people had lied to me all my life. That people deceived me all my life. Amen. And the things that they called me, the things that they said to me. Amen. That was way beneath, my God, who it is that I really was. It was a totally opposite of who I was. But I had to come into that awakening because the truth of the matter of fact is I lived as some of those things. I lived. They words became who I was until I woke up to truth. I had to wake up to truth. I had to stop living under the falsehood of what others had said and also what society had labeled me. Amen, glory to God, thank you, Jesus, hallelujah. I don't care, amen, glory to God. The doctor may have diagnosed you, amen, or the clinic may have diagnosed you, but my God, in the name of Jesus, glory to God, hallelujah. When are you going to come into a place of in your true identity? And when are you going to step into, amen, glory to God, and move and operate into the report of the Lord? It says, who report are you going to believe? And so you got to understand, whenever somebody said something negative about you, that was some form of report. And you got to figure out, what report am I going to believe? See, because remember when the Israel, when they believed the negative report, or they believed the negative report, it cost them, amen, the first generation of Israel that came out of Egypt, it cost them the promised land. And many of us right now, it is causing us right now, we are not living a life of abundance with Jesus Christ have given unto us. We're not living in the land of milk and honey. Amen. We're not living in peace. We're not living in joy. Oh my God, help us, God, in this place. Because somebody lied to us. We received the bad report that we believed, and we took on the bad report, and that thing became our very life essence, amen, and it got us wandering in the wilderness, and God is saying, for such a time as this, amen, you have been around that mountain too long, it's time to break free, amen, glory to God, yeah, God, hallelujah, it's time to break free, amen, break free in the name of Jesus, amen, and go and possess the promise, go and be who it is that God has called you to be. in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. So I wanted to put that out because in a moment we're going to deal with King Saul in the book of 1 Samuel. And we're going to look at how falsehood shaped his life, how it ruined his kingdom, how it hindered him, amen, glory to God, from advancing in the truth of God's word. Oh my God, why? Because he was shaped in a false reality of who he thought he was versus when he heard the word of the Lord that he didn't partake in God's word, amen, glory to God. He didn't, amen, truly believe in what it is that God had called for him to do. And the evidence is in the word itself, people of God. Y'all got to hear me out today. Hear the Spirit of the Lord on today. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. And even as you identify with the word and in the text of people of God, in the word of God, amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Let this word awaken on the inside of you that your life will be changed, that you will break free from falsehood. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. That you will break free from the negative reports, the lies and deceptions, that stuff that they said about you. When you come into the truth and believe the truth and what God has said about your life, it's going to become a game changer. It's going to become a game changer. Amen. All for the glory of God. All for the glory of God, people of God, my God. In the majestic name of Jesus. So let's talk about it here, people of God. Let's talk about it. Let's walk through this word of truth. Here we go. 1 Samuel chapter 9, verse 20. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. The scripture says, "But as for your donkey that were lost 3 days ago, do not be anxious about them, for they have been found. On whom is all the desire of Israel? Is it not on you and all of your father's house?" Amen. Lord God, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. And I love the fact that even Saul's interpretation of this thing, right? Because the prophet just told him, amen, that the desire of Israel is upon him and his father's house, saying unto him, amen, you guys, hallelujah, glory to God, have found favor. Amen. Let him know that you got favor. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. And so here we go. My God. Here we go in the word of truth. So he says, "And Saul answered and said, am I not a Benjamite of the smallest of the tribe of Israel? And my family, the least of all the families of the tribes of Benjamin. Why then do you speak to me this way?" See, some people will take this right here, right? And they would look at it as Saul being humble, right? That him being humble, him being, amen, glory to God, thank you, Jesus, hallelujah. But evidence as we go into previous, as we're going to go into the chapters that precede 1 Samuel chapter 9, we're going to see that it wasn't a place of humility, but it was a place of false identity. It was a place where he defined who he was based upon, amen, the tribe that he was from, based upon, my God, the family, amen. So God would choose him being a Benjamite from the smallest tribe, and then would take the smallest family out of that tribe and pick somebody from there. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Said the least of them. He said the least of them. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. The last will become first, and the first will become last. And, amen. Glory to God. And God is just so awesome like that, because He will take you from the bottom, right, and rise you up to the top. He is the one that builds up kingdoms and tear them down. Amen. And he's already predestined things in our lives. And God want to take us from the bottom and raise us to the top. But, amen, glory to God, thank you, Jesus. But it's one thing to be taken from the bottom and risen to the top. But because I have a bottom mindset, because I walk in a place of false identity, because, oh, help us, Holy Ghost, because I walk in falsehood, my God, glory to God, thank you, Jesus, I never get to fulfill or enjoy the benefit of the elevation in God. There's so many people in the body of Christ, even now, that God has raised up, that God raised from absolutely nowhere and nothing. And God raised them up in the place of his choosing for their life. But they got in that place, and because of how they think about themselves and who they are, they did the same thing that Saul did. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you. When you have an identity crisis, you will compromise your position and your promise. And so many are doing that. Why? Because of feet. Because you, amen, glory to God, thank you, Jesus, hallelujah. Because they want to be accepted. We have so many people that are doing that right now in the body of Christ. And if you're one of those, in the name of Jesus, just be free. Be free. Be free. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Be free in the name of Jesus. And what it is that God has called forth for you to do in your life. No longer be hidden in the hurt, the pain, the shame that keeps you from propelling into your destiny, people of God. Help us in this place, Holy Ghost, my God. So here we go. Amen. And so because he's thought of himself so small, and so we got to stop thinking of ourselves so small. And then you get those that God will raise up, and because, amen, glory to God, thank you, Jesus, hallelujah. Then you get all of the pride and all of this other stuff that was set in, and that will cause you to lose the kingdom, that will cause you to lose what it is that God has given unto you. So let's talk about this thing, right? Glory to God. So here we go, and we got chapter 9 covered. Amen. He thought of himself as being small. He didn't think that he was good enough. How many of us are in places even right now that we don't feel like we're qualified for the job? We don't feel adequate enough for the place that God has placed us. But I want to say this, and I want to speak this into your spirit, man, on today, that you are more than enough. You're more than qualified. You're more than capable. Why? Because he chose you. Glory to God. He didn't choose you based upon the way the world would do the choosing. He chose you before you ever got here. Amen. Before any history ever manifested in your life, you was already chosen for the assignment. And amen. And because he had already predestined you for the assignment, he custom built you and made you for it in the name of Jesus. And the enemy been feeding you lies of deception of falsehood that now got you in a mental place in your life and in the emotional state in your life that you don't feel that you're enough, that you don't feel that you are qualified for that in which God has called forth in your life. But we break the strongholds of the enemy right now in the name of Jesus. And every word curse, every line deception, every word of falsehood that's been spoken over your life, we break it right now in the name of Jesus. We're declaring and decreeing in this place that your memory systems in your loins, your memory system in your mind, your memory system in your heart, your memory system, that it will no longer agree, amen, with the words of falsehood that have been spoken over your life, that right now in the name of Jesus, glory to God, that those places of agreement is now broken. Hallelujah. Glory to you. You are no longer in covenant with falsehood. In the name of Jesus, glory. Oh my God, glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. In the name of Jesus, glory to God. My God, hallelujah. Oh my God, my God, my God. And so Saul would be anointed, become anointed by Samuel over in chapter 10. Amen. Hallelujah. He will get a private anointing. He give him a private anointing. Amen. Glory to God. As in a symbol of being set apart. Amen. Glory to God. And empowered by God to do the work that God had called for him to do. But let us be reminded of the prophet, amen, the prophet Jeremiah, people of God. Amen, glory to God. And someone will take us over there real quickly. Amen, in the name of Jesus, glory to God. Let us be reminded of the prophet Jeremiah. We got the prophet Jeremiah, who God is commissioning into the office of the prophet. Oh, bless your name. That he's being commissioned to the office of the prophet. Check this out in the commissioning of the prophet, because I want you to see and understand people of God, because see, so many people, they're living in such a place of falsehood, they're awaiting, amen, for somebody else to conform them or affirm them in the call in which God has called forth in their life. But I want you to check this out. Both we're in right now, both Old Testament. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Where we see Samuel, amen, glory to God, amen, anointing, what's his name? Saul. Right. Saul is king. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. But I want to let us look at the process in which God does for us all. So right now in chapter 10, verse 1 of 1 Samuel, the word says that Samuel took a flask of oil and poured it on his head and kissed him and said, It is not because the Lord has anointed you commander over his. Is it not because the Lord has anointed you commander over his inheritance? Oh, Jesus. Amen. Glory to God. So he get this private anointing. Amen. He get anointed privately. Amen. As king, but he's going to get ready to have it done openly. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Glory to God. But here, amen, I was talking about, so let's look over at the prophet Jeremiah, because we understand with this prophet anointing, it is just letting, amen, it be known that he's being set aside. the same thing happened to King David. Amen. Glory to God. So, but let's look over here in this prophet's life real quick. Amen. Glory to God. It said, verse 5. It said, here we go. He said, before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you was born, I set you apart. I appointed you as a prophet to the nations. Amen. Glory to God. So your appointment, your appointment has already been placed. It has already been sanctioned for your life, people of God. You've been appointed to do this thing, but not only that, you've been set aside. Amen. So this anointing here in 1 Samuel 10:1, he's being set aside. Amen. Glory to God for the service of the work of the Lord in which God has called him to do to be king over Israel. And he's in his prophet anointing. We got prophet Jeremiah in being, amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. God is conforming him in the office that he's called him to in Jeremiah 1:5. Amen. Glory to God. And we see God setting both of them apart, but we're seeing them being set apart, right, in a different manner. Amen. We're seeing them being set apart in a different manner. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. And so for King Samuel, it was a private anointing that set place. And even we find the same thing happened to King David. Amen. Glory to God. Right here, we just hear the Lord speaking to him what it is that he said in Jeremiah chapter 1. Amen. Glory to God. We see the same thing happen to Prophet Isaiah. Amen. Glory to God. When we look at these prophets and we're looking at the God conforming them in their call. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. That was not an anointing. Amen. We didn't see them being set apart this way. Also, when we look at what's Moses. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. When Moses was set aside to lead Israel out of Egypt. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We see that there were that God set him aside, but the private, the setting aside was not done in the same manner in which Saul was in. So I just want us to understand that, because some of us, we get very confused. We get very tied down. We get, we miss out moving into purpose and what it is that God has called for us to do, because we're waiting for affirmation, amen, from man. Oh my God, hallelujah. But nevertheless, here we go. So he anoints him and set him aside for the service of kingship. And then when he anoints him and set him aside for kingship, you know, amen, glory to God, thank you, Jesus. He gave him signs on what was going to take place and everything, amen, glory to God. And everything happened just as the prophet said it unto him. He, amen, glory to God, thank you, Jesus. He gave him 4 signs. He said, he let him know, amen, that there were going to be some things that was going to manifest as he was traveling back home. He told him that he would meet 2 men who would assure him that the donkeys that he was looking for, that they was found. And it happened, right? He then told him that he would meet 3 travelers up to worship at Bethlehem, and that happened as well. Amen. He let him know that these travelers, see, they was going to worship, right? Amen. Oh my God. Amen. Word of God. They was going to worship, and as they was going to worship, they was carrying 3 goats and 3 loaves of bread and a third of skin of bottle of wine, right? And so they was going to worship. I mean, they was going to use the bread to offer, amen, they was using that offer as holy bread, right, in their place of worship. But what happened when they greeted Saul, they gave him the two loaves of bread that they was going to use to worship. Amen, glory to God. And this was another sign or another, there was a form of accepting, amen, the call. Amen, glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. As he accepted the bread. Amen. Amen. And so by accepting the bread, it was a symbolization that he accepted the legitimacy of his appointment to be king. Now, he may have done that physically, but we're going to be seeing in a moment how mentally, emotionally, psychologically, amen, glory to God, that it was not so, because he was operating in a place of falsehood, a place of missing identity. He definitely had an identity crisis. He also let him know that as he was going home, that he would meet some prophets. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. They'll be prophesying and things of that nature. So he would, amen. He will come up into the schools of prophets, a school of prophets. Amen. And they will be prophesying. And we know that he accompanied them. Once he came among them, he began to prophesy just as they did. And he would, and the prophet Samuel also prophesied that in his life. And these right here will be the signs, amen, glory to God, amen, that he would fulfill his duty, that he would carry out, well, let me say this, that he is the anointed one, that he was the one that God chosen. Amen, glory to God, thank you, Jesus, let me say it that way. So here we go down. I just wanted to kind of run that down for us. Now, this is where we find where our king, a newly selected king, amen, verse 20 in First Samuel chapter 10. I'm going to start at 19. Israel had identity crisis too, but we'll talk about that later maybe. It said, verse 19, but you have today rejected your God, who himself saved you from all your adversities and your tribulation, and you have said to him, no, set a king over us. Now, therefore, present yourself before the Lord by your tribes and by your clan. And when Samuel had caused all the tribes of Israel to come, the tribe of Benjamin was chosen. When he had chosen the tribes of Benjamin to come near by their families, the family of Matri was chosen, and Saul, the son of Cush, was chosen. This is where we find out he had an identity crisis. Lord, help him. Now, I didn't read or go over the statue of King Saul, which is mentioned in 1 Samuel 19. But I'm sure we'll mention it here. It said, now, but when they sought him, he could not be found. Therefore, they inquired of the Lord further, how has the man came yet? And the Lord answered, there he is hidden among the equipment, right? Now, that's one version. This particular version right here, I like, because it exemplifies even the more, amen, glory to God, thank you, Jesus, hallelujah, or illustrate, right, even the more of what is being said here. So, about him. Okay, so I like this version better. So they inquired further of the Lord, has the man come here yet? And the Lord said, yes, he has hidden himself among the baggage. My God. Identity crisis. Amen. Glory to God. Because here he is appointed, already anointed as king, get ready to be publicly put on display. And you know what? And even right now, make me think about those that, you know, God will be moving and doing things in life. And as soon as you're getting ready to get your breakthrough moment, you're getting ready to advance to another level of glory in God. Amen. Self-sabotage will come in. So, amen. And you'll sabotage yourself from reaching the next height and next dimension and what it is that God has called for you to do. That's because there's an identity crisis going on in you, and you're afraid of success. Amen. Glory to God. Why? Because there's something somewhere on the inside of you that somebody said that you ain't going to be successful, that somebody said, that you ain't going to be anything. There's somewhere, there's a seed somewhere planted that are taking root in your life, and that you causes you to self-sabotage yourself. And so we break the spirit of self-sabotage right now in the majestic name of Jesus. You will no longer sabotage or hinder yourself from moving, going, growing in that in which God has called forth in your life. In the majestic name of Jesus. Glory to God. Glory to God. You shall move in purpose. You shall walk in power. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. You should be exactly everything that God has called for you to be. Nothing missing, nothing lacking. Hallelujah. Glory to God. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory, 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 glory be unto the Lord. I'm telling you. Hey, hallelujah. I'm telling you, God is about to do this thing. God is about to do this thing in your life. He's about to break the stronghold on people of God. My God. And so here he would be. So what baggage are you hiding behind today? What place of insecurity? What place of rejection? What place, amen, glory to God, of low self-esteem, a lack of confidence, a lack of trust, a lack of belief, amen, a doubt, amen, double-mindedness? What's hitting you? The abuse, the mentally, emotionally, sexual abuse that has got you hiding behind who it is that God has called? Is it societal labels that they have placed upon you, placed upon because they looked at your family and determined that you wasn't going to amount to anything? They looked at your color of your skin and determined that you're not going to, you won't be successful. They looked at the community or the environment that you was raised up in and determined that you wouldn't be successful. They looked at your test grades and determined that you wouldn't amount to anything, that you wouldn't be successful. But I'm here to tell you today that the devil is a lie in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. You are everything that God has called you to be. God called you to success. Amen. If you're in the kingdom of God, you can't help but be successful. You just got to break through the barriers of falsehood. You got to take off. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. All of falsehood. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Glory to God. No longer live wrapped up, clothed up in lies and deception of the enemy. The word says, buy the truth and do not sell it, gaining wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. Say, you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. And many of us are not knowing the truth. Look, this is what you got to understand. And what I love about that word, know, it means intimately. Amen. Glory to God. When we think about, when we hear in the word, and when you look over into the book of Genesis, or when you look in situations, when you look at of Jacob and Rachel, and amen, glory to God, it said that he knew her. Amen, glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. That means they became one together. Hallelujah, glory to God. So we got to become one together with truth. Somebody help us out. They mean I got to come into a place of agreement with the truth of God's word. I got to agree with what God has spoken. And when you come into a place of agreement with what it is that God has spoken over your life, when you really come in a place of agreement, you don't walk in a place where you're double-minded. You don't go back and forth. Amen, glory to God. You're not split between two decisions. You just really believe the report of the Lord, and it is what it is. Nothing more, nothing less. Amen, in the name of Jesus. Y'all hear me on? Hear the Spirit of the Lord on tonight. Hear the Spirit of the Lord on tonight, and what it is that he's speaking to the church people of God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. That you may be set free, that you may be made whole, my God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. My God, in the name of Jesus, glory to God, help us in this place. Almighty King. For we got identity crisis in the church. Amen. In Jesus' name, our dynamic people of God, we're going to take a break. Amen. But as we go on break, I do want you to do me a favor. Go ahead and share this broadcast on your social media platforms so that those that you know that they can come in on this powerful conversation. Amen. That they may join us in the church on tonight and hear what the Lord is saying to them. Amen. As we walk through this word of truth, I'm excited about everything that he's releasing. Amen. Everything that he's releasing in our lives, dynamic people of God. The time is now. Amen. The time is now to walk in purpose, to move in destiny. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, and amen. We'll be right back in the church.
Those things that I want in my day, and I speak to those things that I want far away from me. I speak with authority to my expectancy. I call those things that I like as my. To where I want to be. All those things that are not as my reality. It's contingent.
Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. God, I just absolutely love it. I 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 love it. Amen. Hello, victory. Bye-bye, defeat. I'm claiming my victory. When somebody just claim I'm coming out of falsehood, I will no longer live out of a lie. The word says, you declare a thing, if you decree a thing, it shall be established for your life. It is a time of declaration. It is a time to declare who you are, what it is that God has called for you to be. Amen. Glory to God, so that you may walk in your victory, so that you may proclaim it. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. And amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord. And that when you confess it in your mouth, it's because you believe it in your heart. My God, so that it'll manifest in your life. In the majestic name of Jesus. I do want to thank you guys for sharing the broadcast one tonight. In the name of Jesus. Glory to God. Thank you so much for getting it out, sharing on your social media platforms, texting the app out to other people. So that they can get on and sending them the radio station website as well. I bless God for you. I bless God for you. Amen. In the majestic name of Jesus, glory. Glory be unto God in this place. You guys are just absolutely, you guys are absolutely amazing. Amen, amen, and amen. In the majestic name of Jesus, I will make sure on tonight, I think I forgot last week, to do the five top country shout out, but we'll make sure that we get our shout out in on tonight. Amen. In the majestic name of Jesus, glory, glory, glory be unto the Lord in this place. God just loves you. Know that God loves you. God loves you. Amen. That's why he will come and give us this word of truth. He will come and break down this word of God for our lives. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Glory to God. We bless the name of the true living God for those, amen, that are tuning in from France, from Russia. Bless you. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Glory to God. We thank God for you for joining us in the church on tonight. In the majestic name of Jesus, glory to God. Coming in number three, we have Brazil. Hallelujah, glory to God. Blessed be the name of Jesus. And then we have in the top country countdown, then we have India in the house. Amen. And then Nigeria, look at God. Amen. Glory to God. Just spreading us out to the four corners of the earth. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Glory to God. Bless you, United Kingdom. Bless you, Ireland, as well, for joining us in the church on tonight. In the name of Jesus. Glory to God. And let me not forget my amen, my hometown, my country, amen, the USA. Wow. Bless you, bless you, bless you, bless you, bless you. In the name of Jesus, glory to God. Also for those that are listening to us from platforms where we're able to chat, amen. If you have any questions, comments, or you want, desire prayer, you can go ahead and drop it right on there. Or you can also email us, amen, at info@inthechurch.com, and we'll pray for you. Again, that is info@thechurch.com. Amen. In the majestic name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. So we just bless the name of Jesus in this place. Amen. So let us get back to this word. We was, amen, glory to God. So I just bless God for you guys. You know, amen. I am Apostle Jerron Shane, so, and I am your host at the In the Church TV and radio broadcast, where we're shining the light of God's word in the church on the good, the bad, and the ugly. Amen. In the majestic name of Jesus. Amen. Because God is doing this thing. God is doing this thing. God is doing his thing. Amen. For his people. And so we were dealing with 1 Samuel. We were dealing with the identity crisis. We were dealing with the identity crisis that the prophet Samuel was having. Amen. Hallelujah. The issue that Prophet Samuel was having, people of God. And so as he was dealing with his issue or his insecurity, that he had or that he displayed, people of God, my God, in the name of Jesus, we thank the true living God. Amen. For such a time as this, for such a time as this, that he, amen, glory to God, thank you, Jesus, that he would, amen, that he would do it for his children, that he'll do it for his children, amen, in Jesus' name. Amen, amen, and amen. So, back over here. So, it got time for him to be anointed. And they said, we're in 1 Samuel chapter 10, verse 21, amen, 22. Glory to God for those who are just joining us for tonight. And so, we got this king who had been anointed, appointed by God. And here he go hiding behind the baggage. And they had to seek the Lord. He was so hidden behind his mess that they had to seek the Lord. And see, Saul was in a place where he didn't feel adequate. He didn't feel inadequate for the position that he was called for. And that's many of us that God has called into position. And because you don't feel confident in the call, or you don't feel that you measure up in the call in which God has called forth in your life, you are hiding behind the baggage. You don't show up confidently. You don't show up boldly. When you show up, you're not showing up in the best of you, in the greatness of you, and what it is that God has called forth in your life, people of God. Here he is hiding. Amen. Glory to God. And even now, you know, I see leaders in the church and deal with leaders in the church as well. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus, who operate in falsehood. Amen. And because they don't feel sufficient enough, they try to overcompensate as well. And we can look at some leaders in the Bible that does the same thing, but they overcompensate and they hurt those in who they should be loving on. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. They inflict pain on those who God has entrusted in them. Why? Because they're leading and they're bleeding. They're leading and bleeding at the same time. And they're causing shipwrecks. Amen. They're causing shipwrecks by Jesus to take place. Because, amen, glory to God, they're not confident in who they are. They're not confident in their call. They're not in a place where they are trusting God, amen, in their purpose. Glory to God, thank you, Jesus. So they're being hindered. They're being hindered from moving in their greatness. My God, help us. Lord, help us in this place. I mean, Lord, help us in this place, in the name of Jesus, glory to God, so that we would know, we won't show up small. We'll stop showing up small on people of God, amen, in the majestic name of Jesus. Hallelujah, glory, glory, glory to God in this place, in the name of Jesus. So identify your baggage, because I want to give you guys some solutions real quickly on tonight. Identify what is your baggage. Identify your place of insecurity and identify your place. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Identify that place. Hallelujah. So Identify those places so that you can rise up in the power and the truth of God's word. Amen, in the majestic name of Jesus. And so, amen, hallelujah. So when you identify those places, now you got to confront it. I tell you guys all the time, what you don't confront, you can't conquer. And so the moment that you'll confront whatever the ism is or whatever it is that you guys are dealing with, then you will be able to conquer those things. And you will no longer be hidden behind the hurt, the shame, the disappointment. Amen. You're no longer be hidden, people of God, behind the confusion and the lack. In the name of Jesus, glory to God. Hallelujah, glory. Oh, thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Amen. Glory to God. So that you can stop showing up small and you can stop hiding behind the baggage. And you go and find what the word of God says about those places in your life. You go and identify and you go, amen, and see what thus says the Lord. And you begin to take that word of God and you begin to meditate on the word of God. Amen. You have to meditate. Amen. He said, look, meditate on the word of God day and night so you can be successful in all your ways. The reason why you have to meditate on the word of God, amen, glory to God, so that you can really become one with the word. Remember a moment ago, or maybe it was in last segment, that I said that we got to become in one. We got to come in one with the word. We got to know the word. We got to know the truth so that we'll be set free. We got to, amen, glory to God, come into one with it. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Glory to God. And so here we go with this King Saul. So eventually they went and got him after God revealed where he was. Amen. As God told where he was and had them to go and get him. Amen. From behind the baggage that he was under. And I want to say this. I want to make sure that I say this and we get this cleared as well before I shift. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Here we go. So they acquired further in the Lord, verse 23. So then it said, they ran and brought him out, and he stood among the people. He was a head taller than all the others. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Remember, in for those who are familiar with the account of King Saul, amen, that the word tells us that he was a handsome young man. He was much taller than everyone else. He was just, you know, uniquely designed. Amen. Glory to God. And that itself, you know, sometimes people of God, our uniqueness, sometimes because we are unique, many a times we don't understand that the uniqueness is what brings our value. That's our, and I'm going to use a word which is really a business term, but that's our value position, right? Amen, glory to God, thank you, Jesus. That's what makes us, you know, unique. That makes us like nobody else. And so many times we feel ashamed or we feel awkward because of that uniqueness, right? It should be a place because the society has caused you to think like that. That's why he told us, don't be conformed to the pattern of the world, but be transformed by the renewing of the mind. And when we become transformed by the renewing of the mind, we understand that, amen, glory to God, that everything about us is good, that we are perfectly entitled, lacking absolutely nothing, that we're created the way that we're created because that's the way God designed us for the work that he has called for us to perform, that we are kingdom built, amen, glory to God. We're kingdom designed for a special purpose. And so we talk the way we talk, we look the way we look, and all these other attributes that we have is because, amen, I'm going to God, they're necessary for us, amen, to move and operate and maneuver in what it is he's called for us to do. And so many times we're ashamed of our uniqueness when that should be the place that we should really be proud of, because that is what allow us to stand out. That's what allow you to stand out of the crowd, right? Amen. That is that place that allows people to identify exactly who you are. That is the mark that's in you that nobody else have. We're talking about identity crisis here. Amen. Glory to God. But usually that place right there, that's the place that the world has made us to feel ashamed because we don't do it this way and we don't do it that way, and cause us to compare ourselves to other people and bury our uniqueness. My God, we're talking about identity crisis in the church. Oh, help us, Jesus. Hallelujah, glory to God. We're talking about identity crisis. Amen. And we'll be back at it again in 3, because there's, we'll have a 3 and a 4 series, because I have 3 other areas that I definitely want us to deal with as well, people of God. I definitely got to go to Genesis 1. Word of God, we're going to end this series in Genesis 1, but we got to go to Hebrews, I think it's chapter 10 or chapter 8. Amen, word of God, thank you, Jesus, hallelujah. And then we got to go, I think it's Matthew or Mark somewhere. Amen, word of God, thank you, Jesus. But these in the book of Hebrews and the book of Matthew and Mark, we're going to look at Jesus, amen, and when he identifies himself. And I do want to, when he talks about who he is and who he's been called and things of that nature. But in addition, what I do want to talk about and deal with as well is I want to look at the disciples. Amen. I want to look at the Apostle Paul as well. Amen. In as he walks in the identity in which God has called forth in his life. So we're just going to have a ball just walking out this series, people of God. But I know it's for a purpose. It's not on coincidence that we're right here. So here we go. Back over here. We're over in, I think this is chapter 12 of 1 Samuel, because I want to close out Samuel today. Amen. Samuel today. As we're dealing with King Saul. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We got to go to verse 12 or somewhere down there. Amen. Now, King Saul, God gave him a specific assignment. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. And now he was chosen to go and kill off, right? He was supposed to go and kill the Ammonites. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Or, amen, glory to God. I may have it wrong. But, amen. And so he was supposed to, God gave him a specific assignment. He said, go there, kill off everything and everybody. My God. He said, kill off everything and everybody. The Amalekites. He's supposed to totally destroy them, and he did not. It's in chapter 15, actually. And so Samuel here, he said, Samuel also said to Saul, the Lord sent me to anoint you king over his people of Israel. Now, therefore, hear the voice of the words of the Lord. Now, God appoint us, and the appointment that he's appointed us to, the amen, glory to God, the position, he also has specific assignments for us to do. And so here was one of King Saul's assignment. And look at how he leaded his assignment, and it's going to just show you how he never really accepted that he was qualified or he was capable enough to be king, right? So he said, therefore, hear the voice of the words of the Lord. Thus says the Lord of hosts, I will punish the Amalekites for what they did to Israel, how he ambushed him on the way when he came up from Egypt. Now go and attack the Amalekites and utterly destroy all that they have, and do not spare them. Kill both men and women, infant and nursing child, ox and sheep, camels and donkeys. So, amen, he got the assignment, but he failed to complete the assignment. Amen, glory to God. He got down there. Verse 9 tells us, amen, glory. I'm going to go to verse 7. Amen. And Saul attacked the Amalekites from Avilah all the way to Shur, which is east of Egypt. He also took Ag, King Ag of the Amalekites, alive. He was supposed to kill him. That wasn't. And he said, and Ella destroyed all the people with the edge of the sword. But Saul and the people spared King Og and the best of the sheep, the oxen, the fattening, the lamb, and all that was good, and was unwillingly to utterly destroy them. He said he was unwilling to utterly destroy them, but everything despised and worthless that they utterly destroyed. Amen. And so we see that there was some covetousness there as well, and greed that was there, because God said wipe it out, but they want to keep what was good. And, you know, they want to do what they want to do. We can't do what we want to do, amen, in the assignment of the Lord. No, we got to follow it all the way out, all the way through. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. So check this out. Verse 10. Amen. I'm gonna run through this a little bit. Amen. Glory to God. It said, the word of the Lord came to Samuel, and he said this, I greatly regret that I have set up King Saul as king, for he has turned back from following me and has not performed my commandments. And it grieved Samuel, and he cried out to the Lord all night. So when Samuel rose early in the morning to meet Saul, it was told Samuel, saying, Saul went to Carmel, and indeed he set up a monument for himself. And he has gone on around, passed by, and gone down to Gilgal. You see how this pride, oh my God, this pride don't even sit in over here. Bless him, Lord. Then Samuel went to Saul, and Saul said to him, blessed are you of the Lord. He said, I have performed the commandment of the Lord, which was not, he did. But Samuel said, what then is this bleating of the sheep in my ears, and the lowing of the oxen which I hear? And Samuel said, they have brought them from the Amalekites, for the people spared the best of the sheep and the oxen to sacrifice to the Lord your God, and the rest we have utterly destroyed. Then Samuel said to Saul, be quiet, and I will tell you what the Lord said to me last night. And he said to him, speak on. Amen. And we hear that God rejected him. So here we're going to hear in Saul's own words, as Samuel continues to have conversation, he's telling him what the Lord, he said, then the Lord sent you on a mission and said, go and utterly destroy the sinners, the Amalekites, and fight against them until they are consumed. Why then did you not obey the voice of the Lord? Why did you swoop down on the spoils and do evil in the sight of the Lord? And Samuel said, but I have obeyed the voice of the Lord and gone on the mission on which the Lord sent me and brought back Agag, king of the Amalekites. I have utterly destroyed the Amalekites. I don't know what's going on with King Saul and his whole mindset here. But it says, but the people took the plunder, the sheep, and the oxen, the best of the things, and which should have been utterly destroyed to sacrifice to the Lord. And so Samuel goes on and on. Then Saul says, I have sinned, this is verse 24, for I have transgressed the commandment of the Lord and your word, because I feared the people and obeyed their voice. He compromised. But he compromised his position. He compromised the promise of God. Help us, Jesus. He compromised his position and he compromised his promise of God. My God, in the name of Jesus, glory to God. And so because he compromised, he found himself in a place where now God himself have rejected him. God himself is rejecting him. My God. In the name of Jesus, glory to God. We just, my God. So people of God, we have to do exactly what it is that God has said and God has spoken into the life of the people. We got to follow the directions all the way out. So we're talking about identity crisis. We can stay here with identity crisis. So because he feared the people and he obeyed their voice, why did he fear the people? He feared that the people was going to reject him. He feared that the people wasn't going to follow him. Don't this sound like some of our leaders right here? Oh, my God. Our leaders right here, right now, amen, glory to God, they take the highest bidder. They're afraid to speak the truth. Why? Because they think people are going to leave the church. And so they compromise the word of God. And so when you compromise the word of God, guess what? Amen, glory to God, thank you, Jesus. If you reject God, God reject you. Oh, my God, help us in this place. Amen, glory to God, thank you, Jesus. We got so many leaders that have identity crisis. When you can sit in and tell a lie, amen, and liberally just to see the people, just so, amen, glory to God, they can stay and be a part of the congregation or whatever it is that needs to be, that it surely says that you have identity crisis. Why? Because you're not standing in the boldness of God's word, because you fear the people. And because you fear the people, you're obeying their voice. You're telling them, you're ministering to them what it is that they want. You're ministering to them out of their flesh. You're ministering to them, let them say, yeah, it's okay. Amen, glory to God. You can fornicate. You can commit adultery. You can live an alternate lifestyle, right? Amen. You can be homosexual and all this other stuff. You tell them they don't have to do what it, I mean, so many words. They don't have to do what it is that God has called for them to do. They can stay in a place of doubt and insecure and all this other stuff. That it's okay that they lie, and God said, look, amen, they can break fellowship with God, and you still saying they in fellowship with God, amen, and it's a lie from the pit of hell. Why? Because, you don't want them to reject you. But your serious issue needs to be that you don't want God to reject you. Because you don't want to wake up and be in hell because you didn't tell somebody, amen, glory to God, thank you, Jesus, how that they was going to hell if they didn't get their life right. We have a serious identity crisis in the church. As we see, because Saul never felt sufficient from the beginning. He never felt like he measured up. And so he compromised. And there's so much compromising going on in the church. And it's called Samuel. Look what it calls Saul's life. It caused him to lose the kingdom. He was so afraid of man that he disobeyed God. And that is just going on right here, right now. Just around the world. And we're going to talk about these leaders, that's manipulating, deceiving the people. Amen, glory to God. You know, got people thinking that, yeah, it's if you don't have sex with me, you're going to hell. Really? First of all, amen, word of God, thank you, Jesus. That is just not in the word of God. I'm going to hell if I do, because I'm going to break covenant with the Lord. But you got people manipulating. You got, amen, word to God. You got people manipulating, deceiving. That's why we got to have this own personal relationship with God ourselves. You see all type of foolishness that's going on in the world, amen, in just different parts and different countries and things of that nature. You got, you know, one pastor telling the women in the church not to wear underwear because, of, like, where's that in the Bible? No, you're just nasty and freaky, and amen, glory to God, you have an identity crisis. That's an identity crisis. Something going on with you that you ain't lining up in the measure of God's word. But some things going on inside of you that you'll compromise the truth, and you'll just, you know, you just let people, yeah, it's okay for you to do that. And you just accept the behavior. We bring no correction, no rebuke for the foolishness that people do against the word of God. God is holding you accountable, leaders. Help us in this place in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. You guys, amen, hallelujah. I gave you the solution earlier, amen, hallelujah, on how to overcome, amen, the place of inadequacy, the place where you feel that you don't measure up and what it is that God has called for you to do. We're getting ready to leave the church on tonight, but we're going to be back next week in the word of God, just walking through it. But if somebody somewhere needs to be set free, that I do know, amen, glory to God, thank you, Jesus, hallelujah. There's a whole lot of identity crisis that's going on inside of the church, amen, in the name of Jesus, glory to God. So here we go, people of God. Identify your area of baggage. Identify the thing that got you feeling that you're inadequate, that you're not more than enough, that you feel that you don't measure up to the call that God has called, that make you feel that you can't be successful in what it is that God has called forth in your life. Go ahead and do that for me. Go ahead and make that happen. Hallelujah. In the name of Amen. So that you can confront it. Find what thus says the Lord in the word about it and begin to meditate on it day and night. Don't let it depart from your mouth. Faith is going to come by hearing the word of God. The word says, meditate on the word day and night so they will not depart from your mouth. Amen. Glory to God. Don't turn from the left or the right into you so you can be successful in all your ways. Amen. In the majestic name of Jesus. Glory to God. Just wanted to make sure I release some strategies in your life as well that you can take hold onto it. Start to fight with the word of God. Believe the word of God. Live in the word of God. Amen. Live in the word that God has called for your life. Believe. You cannot receive or manifest in your life until you move and operate in the place that you believe. For thus says the Lord for your life, dynamic people of God. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Glory to God. So with that being said, dynamic people of God, hallelujah. Hallelujah, glory. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We just bless the name of the true living God in this place. God is absolutely faithful. We'll meet you definitely next week in the church, dynamic people of God. We want to thank you for joining us in the church on tonight. As we have had a phenomenal time, we look forward to greeting you in the church next week. But until then, let us connect on our social media platforms. Follow us on Facebook and Instagram at In The Church. Also on Twitter at In The Church Live. We look forward to continuing our conversation with you. You can also go to our website,
at www.inthechurch.com to re-listen to this program. In addition, to email your thoughts, your comments, and any show topic requests. So we look forward to connecting with you, dynamic people of God. As always, let us continue to follow the word of truth so that we will be set free. Until next time, people of God, we look forward, amen, to meeting you in the church. Let us go in the love, joy, peace, favor, and the anointing of our most holy Savior, who is none other than Jesus Christ. And it is in his most holy and majestic name that we have convened in the church. Amen, amen, and amen.